Bezier control points, Bezier, whatever you want to call them, we got to learn how they work. And we're about to show you right now.
We have a clip here of a forest and a clip of a cat connected below it. We'll start by adding a mask to our subject. We'll select the forest clip and position the playhead over it. We'll navigate to the effects menu on the right. Click on this icon to open it. We'll locate the shape mask and drag it onto our clip and make some adjustments in the viewer. Then we'll hold Control, click, and choose Convert to Control Points. And when this window comes up, just click Convert. And look at that. We have a complex mask to work with. In the viewer, we can hold Command and click on a Bezier or curved point to turn it into a linear point. And opposite of that, we can hold Command and drag a linear point to turn it into a Bezier curve. Alternatively, we can hold Control, click on a point, and choose Linear for linear points, or Smooth for Bezier curves. Very smooth would be a B-spline, which we'll cover in our B-spline control points tutorial linked in the description below. We'll set it to smooth so that we can explore the Bezier curves. First, we'll show you how to adjust the curves using these on-screen controls. To adjust the length of the curve's handle, we can simply drag the handle. If we want to move the curve in a 45-degree angle, we can hold Shift while dragging in any direction. And to break the relationship between the handles, we can hold Option while dragging either handle. This will cause adjustments to one handle to have no effect on the other. Alternatively, we can hold Control and click on a tangent handle point and choose Break Handle. From here, we can adjust the handle individually. If we need to lock the handles together again, we can hold Control, click the handle point, and choose Link Handle. Now any changes to this handle will affect the other. And if we want to align the tangent handles to 180 degrees, we'll hold Control and click the handle point and choose Align Handles. The handles are now forming a perfect straight line. Last but not least, if we want to modify handles for more than one control point, we'll hold Shift, select both points, and drag one handle to affect the others. Don't forget to link any unlinked handles if needed.
And that's how Beziers work in Final Cut Pro.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
I know, it's the end. You're going to miss us, but have no fear. We've got several new Final Cut Pro tutorials coming after this.